बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। आज का हमारा जो टॉपिक है दैट इज अबाउट केमिस्ट्री क्लास 10 चैप्टर नंबर 9। चैप्टर नंबर 9 इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप चैप्टर इन क्लास 10। वी हैव ऑलरेडी रेड अबाउट चैप्टर 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 एंड चैप्टर नंबर 8 अप टू चैप्टर नंबर 8 इन क्लास 9 एंड चैप्टर नंबर 9 इन क्लास 10। द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 10 इज चैप्टर नंबर 9 एंड द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 9 इज केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम एंड our today's lesson is about chemical reactions and in chemical reactions we study about reactants, products, irreversible reactions and reversible reactions. What are reactants? Reactants are those substances that combine in a chemical reaction. For example, in a chemical reaction between nitrogen and hydrogen to form ammonia, nitrogen and hydrogen are called reactants. And what are products? Products are those substances that are formed during a chemical reaction. Chemical reaction ke dauran jo cheez hame product ke taur par hasil hoti hai, that are called products. And products are written after the sign of arrow and reactants are written before the sign of arrow. For example, we have an example between nitrogen, hydrogen, and they when one mole of nitrogen combines with 3 moles of hydrogen, they form 2 moles of ammonia. In this chemical reaction, nitrogen and hydrogen are called reactants, and ammonia that is formed during a chemical reaction, that is called a product. There are some substances that are formed as a byproduct in some chemical reactions. For example, when sodium hydroxide and animal fat or vegetable oil, are mixed up, they form soap. And as a byproduct, glycerin is produced. In this chemical reaction, glycerin is called a byproduct. In the same way, during the process of photosynthesis, oxygen is produced as a byproduct. And the substances that are written on the sign of arrow, for example, in a chemical reaction between during the formation of ammonia, when nitrogen and hydrogen are reacted with each other, nickel is written on the sign of arrow and nickel is called a catalyst. Catalysts are those substances which increase the rate of reaction without appearing in the final product. Catalyst हम उर्दू में हमें कहते हैं अमल अंगेज, ये रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन को बढ़ा देते हैं लेकिन फाइनल प्रोडक्ट में ये जाहिर नहीं होते। इनका काम ये होता है कि ये रिएक्टेंट्स की आपस में रिएक्ट करने की जो शरह है इसको क्या कर देते हैं, स्पीड अप कर देते हैं, इसको इंक्रीज कर देते हैं ताकि तेजी के साथ रिएक्टेंट्स जो है वो इनमें कन्वर्ट हो जाए, प्रोडक्ट्स में कन्वर्ट हो जाए। तो द सब्सटेंसेस दैट आर रिटन ऑन द साइन ऑफ एरो, दीज आर कॉल्ड कैटालिस्ट। Catalysts are those substances which increase the rate of reaction, speed up the rate of reaction without appearing in the final product. And the next definition is about irreversible reactions. What are irreversible reactions? Irreversible reactions are those type of reactions in which products do not recombine to form reactants. Some reactions are those reactions in which products can recombine and again form reactants. But in irreversible reaction, products do not recombine to form reactants. There are different kinds of irreversible reactions. For example, we have an example of water molecule. When hydrogen, 2 moles of hydrogen, 1 mole of oxygen reacted, they form 2 moles of water. And irreversible reactions are those reactions in which there is a single sign of arrow that is indicated that these reactions are called irreversible reactions. These are single sign of arrow is put between the reactants and products. They are represented by putting a single arrow between reactants and products. And the next one is reversible reactions. What are reversible reactions? Reversible reactions are very important in a chemical reaction. Reversible reactions are those reactions in which products can recombine to form reactants again. And reversible reactions are represented by putting a double sign of arrow between reactants and products. And there are many examples of reversible reaction. One familiar example of reversible reaction is the formation of hydrogen iodide. When hydrogen, one mole of hydrogen and one mole of iodine react with each other, they are heated up and they form hydrogen iodide. The color of iodine is purple in isolated in a molecular form, and when it reacts with the hydrogen, they form hydrogen iodide. The color of hydrogen iodide is actually colorless. When iodine reacts with hydrogen, they form colorless hydrogen iodide. We can identify easily these reactions in a closed flask. For example, if we have a closed flask and we heat up hydrogen and iodine, reacted with hydrogen and iodine during before the chemical reaction, the color of that reactants are purple color. And after the reaction, when hydrogen and iodine react with each other, they form hydrogen iodide, and the color of hydrogen iodide is colorless. There is no color when hydrogen reacted with iodine and form hydrogen iodide. And when all the reactants are converted into products, these reactions are known as forward reactions. Forward reactions are those reactions when reactants are converting into products, and reverse reactions are those reactions when products are converting into reactants again. Products are converting into reactants again. During the reverse reaction, the color of iodine is again produced. Purple color of iodine is again produced during the reverse reaction. Forward reactions are those in which reactants are converted into products, and reverse reactions are those reactions in which products are converted into reactants again. Before the chemical reaction, the color of iodine is purple, and after a reaction, there is no color of hydrogen iodide. And when these reactions are in reverse direction from products to reactants, color is again produced during that chemical reaction. We can summarize these two chemical reactions in this form. For example, hydrogen and iodine, there is a sign of reversible reaction between hydrogen iodine and hydrogen iodide. That reaction is called a reversible reaction. There is one example of reversible reaction during the formation of hydrogen iodide, when hydrogen and iodine react with each other. And there is another example that is called calcium carbonate. During the decomposition of calcium carbonate, first calcium carbonate decomposes to form calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. And reversible reactions were always occurred in a closed flask, not in an open flask. For example, when we heated up calcium carbonate, carbon dioxide is escaped out when the flask is open, and only the product that is left behind, that is called calcium carbonate. And there is an irreversible reaction. But when the flask is closed, when in a closed flask we heat up calcium carbonate, calcium oxide and carbon dioxide are produced during that chemical reaction. And when all the reactants are converted into products, then products can recombine again to form the reactants. These reactions are called reversible reactions. And reversible reactions can be obtained only in a closed flask, not in an open flask, in which substances can neither leave nor enter during a chemical reaction. These reactions are called reversible reactions. We have read about the four definitions with their examples. Reactants are those substances that can combine in a chemical reaction, and products are the substances that are formed during a chemical reaction. For example, when nitrogen and hydrogen combine, they form ammonia. Nitrogen and hydrogen, these are called reactants, and ammonia that is formed during a chemical reaction. that is called a product. And the next one is irreversible reaction, are those reactions which don't recombine to form reactants, in which the products don't recombine to form reactants. For example, we have two moles of hydrogen, one mole of oxygen, they form two moles of water molecule. The water molecule doesn't recombine to form hydrogen and oxygen again. These type of reactions are called irreversible reactions, and they are represented by putting a single arrow between reactants and products. And the next one is the reversible reaction. Reversible reactions are those reactions in which products can recombine to form reactants again, and they are represented by putting a double arrow between reactants and products. And we have discussed about two examples of reversible reactions. The first one is hydrogen iodide, the formation of hydrogen iodide when hydrogen and iodine reacts with each other. And the second example is decomposition of calcium carbonate. The first, that reaction is called decomposition reaction. And when calcium oxide and carbon dioxide again reacted with each other in a closed flask, calcium carbonate is produced again. When we unite these two reactions, we can write these reactions as CaCO3 reversible reaction, CaO plus CO2. There is a sign of reversible reaction between reactants and products. It means that the rate of converting reactants into products is equal to the rate of reaction in which products are converting into reactants. And this condition, the rate of converting of reactants into products and products into reactants are equal to each other, that is called chemical equilibrium state. That state is called chemical equilibrium state. तो ये आज का हमारा टॉपिक था, केमिकल रिएक्शंस क्या होते हैं. इसमें हमने बेसिक डेफिनेशंस के बारे में पढ़ा. फर्स्ट वन इज रिएक्टेंट्स, प्रोडक्ट्स, रिवर्सिबल एंड इरिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन. इससे नेक्स्ट टॉपिक में हम इंशाल्लाह ताला जो रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शंस हैं इनको ग्राफ की मदद से जो है वो एक्सप्लेनेशन भी करेंगे कि रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन में फॉरवर्ड और रिवर्स रिएक्शंस क्या होते हैं, और इनको ग्राफ की मदद से हम कैसे जो है एक्सप्लेन करते हैं.